Hey, ladies and gentlemen, today is Tuesday, April 19th, sorry. The parts and materials needed for this project were a 3/8 inch hose remnant from Harbor Freight Tools. These range from 3 to 15 feet. You kind of get what you get in the package, I guesstimated when I looked at the package, and this particular hose is approximately 8 feet long. We also sourced up 2 1/4 inch full opening ball valves from Harbor Freight again, and from Home Depot we got Rector Seal number 5 pipe thread sealant, a 1/4 inch galvanized iron street elbow, a 1/4 inch galvanized iron coupler, and 2 1/4 by 5 inch galvanized nipples. This provides the length to get the dump valve out from under the bottom of the compressor all the way out to where I can easily reach it. The first step to your project is to apply your thread sealant to the male threads on each of your pipes and fittings. I applied the thread sealant to each male component and threaded it to the female first, with the exception of the pipe elbow. The pipe elbow was threaded first and then screwed into the tank, tightened, and then the rest was screwed into it. The reason for that is because of the swing of everything. I wouldn't have been able to make it actually thread in had I assembled the elbow to everything else first. Having misjudged the hole size in the bottom of the air compressor tank, I had mistakenly purchased this 3/8 male to 1/4 inch female reducer, otherwise known as a bushing. This was not needed. If you own the Central Pneumatic 29-gallon 2-horsepower oil lubricated air compressor, the tank fitting on the bottom is actually 1/4 inch. You do not need a bushing if you're using 1/4 inch pipe. During the removal of the original valve, we had a little accident where we dropped the compressor onto its back. This unfortunately had the result of crushing the original pressure gauge. This pressure gauge I simply replaced with a Central Pneumatic 200 PSI filled gauge. The new gauge actually operates much smoother than the original. Not pictured is my assembly of the street elbow onto the compressor tank. I simply drained the tank, removed the old valve, applied thread sealant to the male threads on the street elbow. At that point, I installed the elbow onto the tank, making sure that it was tight and making sure that it faced the back of the tank. At that point, I assembled the nipples onto the coupler, and I assembled the dump valve onto the nipple. Then, the one remaining end, I applied pipe sealant to, and installed onto the elbow, and snugged it all down with a pipe wrench. Also not pictured is the reassembly of the air hose. We simply stripped the quick disconnects, the male and female ends, off of the blown hose, applied thread sealant to the male on the new hose, and simply screwed the old quick disconnect pieces onto the new hose, making sure that they're tight. Once installed, the valve was easily accessible from behind the compressor. I simply had to flip the lever parallel to the pipe to open it up, and then 90 degrees to the pipe to close it off. It holds pressure just fine. I have not tried to move the compressor yet. I do suspect that this rig is going to interfere with the rolling of the compressor. I may replace one of the 5-inch nipples with a 4-inch nipple so that I can gain that additional inch of clearance back and be able to more easily move the compressor. Our last step in this project is to uninstall the original coupler from the output side of the air compressor. We simply unscrewed the coupler from the compressor, applied pipe thread sealant to the male ends of the compressor output, and the quarter-inch ball valve, threaded it all together, and then threaded the coupler back on. While we were testing this, we actually did discover that the ball valve that I initially installed, that was sitting in my toolbox as old stock that I was hoping to use, was defective. The second new ball valve that I purchased from Harbor Freight was swapped in its place, and it's working fine. Today is Tuesday, April 19th. It's approximately 10:30 p.m. The compressor just filled up to 150 PSI-ish, a little bit under. I need to set the regulated side down. I want it down around 90. And there we go. And the... Damn it. Sorry about that. I just knocked my pencil sharpener off because my head was where it usually wasn't. Anyway, we're settling down to about 140. That's about what I expect to see. If you take a look here, you can see the valve that I added. Right here. A little hard to get to with me holding the camera, but I've already pressurized the line. That's why you don't hear air whooshing through, but that turns the air on, shuts it off, quick disconnect, new hose, and if you look down below, the dump valve. Now, we're going to come back here in a couple of days and check this. This actually stayed right at this pressure from last Thursday till about 20 minutes ago when I finally tested that valve, well, the valve that was there before, and as soon as I opened that valve, I got air coming out of where it doesn't belong coming out of. So I replaced that valve. We're going to test again, see how long it goes. I'm going to, you see I've got the disconnect turned off, so there's no air going to the pressure line. And as I've mentioned, I'm cleaning the shop, so excuse the mess. But we're going to come over here, bleed off the pressure that's against the hoses. Okay. And you see we've bled off the pressure. Now if you look at my desiccant, I need to dry that desiccant back out. Just stick it in the microwave, nuke it. I'm good, but that's pressure's off, so I've got no risk to the hoses. And we are good to go. We're going to let it sit for a few more days, see how it does. And we're not going to let it pressurize on its own. It's turned off. So there we go. All right, gentlemen and ladies, if there's any watching, I will keep you posted. Thanks. Today is Wednesday, and it's April 20th, 2016. We're 24 hours into this fix, and you can see that we're about 122 PSI. So it looks like I've lost 18 PSI in 24 hours. I honestly can live with that. Flip the lever. The system compresses, power airs up, but as you can hear, no hissing, any of that stuff. So looks like we're good. So time for me to just flip that back off, open up the dump valve, and call it good. That, ladies and gentlemen, is how you fix a compressed air system.